What's up, guys? Dr. Root7 signing in back with a very important update tutorial that is in regards to the latest firmware that has been released by Nintendo, which is 13.0.0. So this tutorial is going to be about making the Atmosphere custom firmware to work with the latest official firmware. I'm going to show you guys how to proceed on with that. So just please follow these steps right from the start until the end. Do not miss one step. Do not skip one step, because this is a very delicate tutorial. Before moving on, just disconnect from the internet and then proceed with the tutorial process. It is going to be a three-step process, which is going to start with the RCM loader and then followed by the SD card from where we're going to update the Atmosphere custom firmware to its latest version, and then we're going to update the official firmware. Go to the link in the description that I am going to be providing. You're going to download Atmosphere version 1.10. This is the latest version that only works with the latest official firmware. Anything else before that is going to break, is not going to work. After downloading the Atmosphere file, just go to the second link that and download the firmware 13.0. This is not available through the all-in-one updater. At the time of making this video, I haven't checked, but a couple of hours before, I didn't find it. So anyways, there was someone who was generous enough to provide us with the latest official firmware, and this repack obviously is being uploaded by NickMoses05. Just check his YouTube channel out, check his page, Facebook page out. So after downloading those files, the latest version, which is Atmosphere 1.10 and the firmware 13.0.0, just extract those files. Let this thing extract. So I already have the Atmosphere version 1.10 extracted. The very first thing that you're going to do is plug in your RCM loader. Okay, this is my RCM loader. Here is the payload.bin file. Just back it up somewhere just in case. So just to let you guys know that this is my first time that I'm trying. I haven't tried this out beforehand. So all you guys are going to see is my first experience. All right, now select this file called Hecate Creator 5.6.1 bin. So copy that and then go back to the RCM loader and then just delete this file and then just paste it here. All right, rename it to payload.bin. All right, so here the part where you need to update the payload in the RCM loader has been done. You can eject the RCM loader. So RCM loader's part is done. Now let's insert the micro SD card. This is the micro SD card. For those who have been following my tutorials, it's pretty basic. By now you guys know how to update the custom firmware. All you have to do is that just go into the extracted folder. So this is my subfolder. So yeah, this is Atmosphere version 1.10. Go into that folder, go into the subfolder, copy all the contents, and then go into your SD card, the root of your SD card, and then just paste it. If it asks for you to place any kind of files, just do it. Go ahead, it's going to be okay. All right, replace all these files in the destination. Okay, so once that completes, extract. Okay, this one has been copied. Extract the, after downloading the zip file of the firmware, this folder will come. Go into that folder, another subfolder will come. These are the files. Go, just copy that subfolder and paste it into the root of your SD card. Everything that needs to be followed in regards to the copying and pasting has been done. After this, there is nothing else that you need to do. After this, you just need to follow these steps onto the Switch. All right, guys, so here I am on my Nintendo Switch. I have already used my RCM loader to inject the payload. So here is the screen. So just follow carefully what you need to do. So you can, for those who are on the EmuNAND, you can just go to launch and then just select EmuNAND. Or for those who are on the SysNAND, you can select SysNAND. By any chance, by using this SysNAND, it breaks the application like tinfoil or like, you know, any other applications that are giving you a hard time to run. Go to payload and then just look for fuse.bin and then just boot the custom firmware through this payload. Before this, prior to this update, We always used to use fuse primary.bin, but not on this update. On this update, use fuse.bin to boot the custom firmware. So I'm going to select fuse.bin and boot the custom firmware. And also make sure that you are not connected to the internet. For me, I have already set up the 90DNS. For those who are wondering, if you guys want me to show you guys how to set up 90DNS to block the Nintendo servers, you can let me know in the comment section. I will just make a short tutorial about it. Turn off your Wi-Fi, like I have said at the beginning of the tutorial. Just turn off your Wi-Fi and stay offline throughout the whole update process. So here I am on the main screen. What I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna show you guys that I have successfully updated my custom firmware to its latest version. If you look closely, it says AMS 1.1.0. So this is the latest version. This is the latest Atmosphere version, and I'm using stock NAND. For those who are going to be on this EmuNAND, it's going to show E instead of the S. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to update the official firmware. So follow this step very carefully in regards to updating the official firmware. What I'm going to ask you guys is that using the full RAM mode of your Nintendo Switch while performing this action in order to avoid any kind of crashes or anything, because it's a delicate process and you don't want to take any chances. What is full RAM mode? I'm going to explain to you in short. If you go into the AFB menu, you can see applet mode, which means that it's not using its full RAM. This thing needs to go away. In order for it to go away, what you need to do is that select one of the applications, press and hold the R button, and then just select a game or an application. Do not select Tinfoil, please. Select any game and then just press A and press A again. Keep on pressing and holding till it takes you to this screen. Now you see the applet mode is gone. It means that it's using its own full RAM mode. So here on the screen, what you need to do is go to Daybreak and then go to install. So Daybreak is the homebrew app that is going to be used in order to update your firmware. So this is the very first folder that is being shown. It will vary from console to console. It might show somewhere else on your system. Just select this by pressing A and then let it highlight these things. Okay, now it says continue. What you're going to do is that select continue. After this, select settings mode. Do not reset to factory settings. If you reset to factory settings, it's going to just mess things up. If you have saved games, if you have anything configured and set up, it's going to mess it up. So always preserve settings. Okay, select driver variant. I'm going to select install FAT32 plus XFAT. Ready to begin update installation. Are you sure you want to proceed? Continue. So this may vary from console to console. The update process might take some time. So I'm not going to just wait, but obviously it's going really faster than usual. I don't have to skip through this. Okay, it says applying update, as you can see. Okay, this is a very important step. After the update has been applied successfully, do not reboot, shut it down completely. All right guys, so I have come across an obstacle. Before resolving it, I'm going to show you guys what is exactly happening or exactly what I'm facing. As I try to boot the custom firmware, what's happening is giving me an error code that you will be seeing, right? Yeah, so this is the error code that is preventing me from booting. I have come across a fix that I'll be showing you guys. The error message that you guys have seen, the one that I have shown on my video, it's related to the custom themes that were installed on my Nintendo Switch. If you are looking to update your system, the stock firmware as well as the custom firmware, just do not for any reason have custom themes installed. So if you have any custom themes installed, just uninstall them and just clear it off. By clearing it off, it means that just have them uninstalled. But still, if you still get that error message after doing this update, then I have pinpointed the root cause of the trouble. It's very easy, it's very like straightforward. So just plug in the memory card into the computer and then just go into the Atmosphere folder, and then inside the Atmosphere folder, look for a subfolder named Contents. So plug in the SD card, go to the Atmosphere folder, look for a subfolder named Contents, and then inside that folder, look for a folder, a numerical folder that is named as, that is numbered as something like this. I don't know if you guys can see it. It's 0100 something, the one that I have highlighted. I'm going to put that on the description so that you guys can see it. Now, coming to the main thing, so I just have a like final couple of stuffs that I need to show you. So system, here under system, you can see that the current version is 13.0.0, AMS is 1.1.0. Now, there is also another thing that needs to be done that is a good idea to do. It's basically you can update your controllers, your Joy-Cons. I don't know what it does, but my Joy-Cons are totally messed up. Maybe it's going to mess up even more. Just kidding, just kidding. I have already updated them, so I won't be able to show the whole thing to you guys. So here is where you're going to find this option under controllers and sensors. Go into under controllers and sensors and then look for update controllers. Here, then it's just gonna ask you or something, or maybe it's just gonna update it. And since I am already updated, it says our controllers are already up to date. And there is also an option to update the dock as well, but you need to have the tablet docked. I'm not going to show you guys that. It's just too much in one simple tutorial video. That was it with the tutorial. Just to do a test run, I'm going to show you guys that everything is running fine. Tinfoil is running perfectly fine. You won't even have to worry about anything. The repacks that have been provided, they come with everything. All the updated files, all the updated stuffs. You don't even have to worry about updating the sick passes or anything like that. So yeah, Tinfoil is running fine, and then I'm just going to run an application and show you guys that that thing is also running without any kind of complication. Yeah, as you can see that this software is running fine as well. So yeah, that was the update tutorial of the official firmware that has been released recently by Nintendo, and also the custom firmware that works with the official firmware. So that was the tutorial. Got a little bit complicated, but always complications leads to different and diverse solutions. So that's why I'm here for, to help you guys out. Obviously, this was something obviously I wasn't looking forward to. Anyways, that was the tutorial. Just make sure to follow from start to finish, and yeah, you should be good to go for Metroid Dread. Looking forward to that. Hopefully Nintendo doesn't, like, you know, put a stick up my ass. So I'm going to end the video on a note saying, again, thank you so much for all the like and support, and yeah, just keep on liking my videos, keep on with the comments. Really appreciate those. And yeah, I will see you guys on the next video. Dr. Root 7 signing off. Peace.